All right, welcome back. When you make homemade pizza, you need a lot of things, except maybe a blender. Think again, but Michelle Luciano from Vitamix is here to show us how you could use it to make unforgettable pizza pies. When you think of making pizza and using a blender, it's just...
It doesn't feel like it.
It's mind-boggling.
But it's those steps along the way in the food processor that makes it, the capabilities that make it work.
Okay.
So big trend right now is cauliflower crust.
Yes.
That's been a lot of people are going gluten-free, and this is just a really great way to, you know, get more vegetables. And in my house, we can't call it a faux pizza, so we call it a pizza-inspired vegetable dish.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, and it's very good
At
marketing.
Least you use the word vegetables.
That's
I would
right.
have to come up with a different word with my 5 and 2-year-old.
Well, and one of the things that make, you can buy, you know, chopped cauliflower, and cauliflower rice is really big, but it's so easy to do as a wet chop in the Vitamix.
Okay.
So what I have in here is about a head of cauliflower, and then I've just covered it with enough water to take it, so it just kind of lifts up a little bit.
Okay.
We're going to go ahead and turn this on. And I'm going to take this and we're going to pulse. Not very many times. Oops. Yep. And then we're going to go ahead and just, I would pour it, like I would do this over the sink.
Okay.
Just to give you the idea. So we would pour it over the colander and you would want to chop this a few more times just to get it to, it took like 3 seconds to do it. Right. So the keto cauliflower crust is making sure we get all that water out. So after I would let it ring through my sieve,
okay,
I then put it into a kitchen towel. And then we go ahead and we, as much as you can humanly possible, get the rest of the moisture out to squeeze it out. And what you get is something that's really kind of dry.
Okay.
You know, like the cauliflower we have here.
Right, right, right.
Look right, so
okay.
to do the crust, I'm gonna go ahead and give it some Parmesan cheese.
Mm-hmm.
I've got, and we're gonna season it, which is what I think makes it better than what you can buy pre-baked.
Right.
I've got some red pepper, some Italian seasonings, and some chia seeds.
Okay, let's.
Yeah, and then we're gonna go ahead and add our egg.
Okay.
And here, the key is that chia seed, because when we add the egg, that liquid is gonna, I don't know if you know, but chias expand, and that's what's gonna be the binder for this.
Okay.
So I would mix this all up, put it in the fridge, cover it up, and through the magic of TV, I've got one that's been sitting for 30
now,
minutes.
Now, how long in the fridge?
About 30 minutes.
Oh, that's
And,
not bad.
You know, you can be, I just wouldn't let it go more than like an hour or so because the chia can get gelatinous a little
bit.
Yeah, if it sits too long. But this one's been sitting up for about an hour. And then again, when we make the crust out of this, you'll see there's still a little bit of liquid content
in there.
Can you
guys see that?
Can you guys see that?
There's a little bit of liquid.
So what we want to do when we go ahead and move it to the, I've got a perforated pizza pan here, and I just put a piece of parchment paper over the top.
Okay.
And then you just kind of want to make sure that you squeeze out any excess liquid, because that is the key. When people say they get mushy cauliflower crust, it's because
right, you pick it up and it like kind of falls out.
Yeah, or it's really soft. It's because they didn't get all that moisture out. So all we're going to do is just like take this cauliflower and just kind of press it into, you know, about a quarter of an inch.
Boy, that looks tasty with all those seasonings.
It really is. And then what we would have done is popped it in the oven.
Okay.
15 minutes at 450, and that's the crust. And then you can dress it just like you would anything else.
Now, with cauliflower pizza and all those seasonings, it doesn't matter. I mean, you don't have to use... I see you brought pesto, which is one of my favorites. Well, I feel like that would be good, but the regular marinara and stuff would be good,
really
too.
It really does. Yeah. It's like the key is you want to watch your water content. So it's like you don't want anything too liquidy because that'll add, again, and make it a little bit crispy. But I made this pesto. I cleaned out my garden because I heard on the weather earlier it's going to might freeze tonight.
So we hear.
So I took out all my basil yesterday and made a huge batch of pesto on the Vitamix, you know, just the basil, olive oil, Parmesan, pine nuts, and it took like 2 seconds. And then this is, the, and then we did a pesto pizza with some feta and tomatoes. But you can do
as much as I don't want to call in the people I work with.
I know it smells
so good. My all-time favorite pizza. I will.
It smells so good, doesn't it?
Serve it up, you guys. Grab yourself a piece. That looks really good.
Is it warm?
You put that in the oven for how long, you said?
That was about 10 minutes, again, at this 450, just to finish it off.
So,
okay. I was going to say, don't.
So it's a rather quick recipe.
It really is. And I do, I mean, just keep in mind that it's a little softer than a regular pizza dough. So it's like you want to, it's more of like a knife and fork kind of thing.
Okay.
But I made this, and I had a little bit of stuff left, and my husband and my daughter were circling last night. Isn't that great?
Wait, we're not taking it from them, are we?
I am very, very...
Oh, well, I had made a little, and they're like, is that one for me? I'm like, no, that's for everybody tomorrow morning. But I made them their
own. Sorry, guys.
And I really thought that they would be, my daughter circled back and finished the whole thing off. And then she even said to me, she goes, can you make just the crust with nothing on it?
Because
she liked the crust.
Really?
Wait, I'm gonna try it. It's so good with the pesto.
We have to go, but before we do, tell them about the deal.
Oh my gosh, we've got
sale.
Yeah, absolutely. So Northeast Ohio is where Vitamix is located. Our headquarters is here. So we are lucky. We've got factory sale coming up on November 2nd and 3rd. You can call 1-800-VITAMIX and get more details on that. But we're really excited. I guarantee you the best prices you've ever seen.
Buy one, it will change your life.
It will change your life.
You can make anything. You can even make pizza.
I love it.